Welcome to Excel 101 Water Resources Management. My name is Andreas de Jong. In today's video, I want to show you how to calculate the seasons and the hydrological year in Excel. The seasons. In most countries, we divide the year into four seasons: spring, summer, autumn, and winter. In the Northern Hemisphere, we have winter from December to February, spring from March to May, summer from June to August, autumn from September to November, and so on. In Excel, we can use the month function to identify the month from any date. Once we have the month, we can derive the season. Let's have a look at the month function. You just type in equals month and link it to a date which is recognized by Excel. Excel recognizes any date between the 1st of January 1900, which is day 1, to any date after that. For example, the 1st of January 2022 is day 44,562, which is the number of days since 1st January 1900. Note that dates before 1st January 1900 are not recognized by Excel, so it will give you an error. The month function will calculate the month as a number between 1 and 12. So January is month 1 and December is month 12. We can calculate the seasons using nested if functions, but there's a smarter way. For this, we will use the lookup function in the array form. You just type in equals lookup and then your array. So for the Northern Hemisphere, it will be lookup, the month. Then you start the array using curly brackets and type in the first month for the start of each season, separated by commas. After the semicolon, you just type in the name of the seasons inside inverted commas, finish the array with another curly bracket, and close the function with a bracket. The water year. In the Northern Hemisphere, the main precipitation events after the summer start in October and carry on throughout the winter. For this reason, the 1st of October is normally the beginning of what is known as the water year or hydrological year. The water year 2022 started on the 1st of October 2021 and runs until the end of September 2022. This means that October, November and December belong to the water year 2022, although they are of course part of the 2021 calendar year. Note that October, November and December all are months which are greater than 9. So to calculate the water year, all we need to do is to check the number of the month. To do this, we just use an if function. If the month is greater than 9, then add 1 to the year. If not, just return the year. The year function is very similar to the month function, so I will not bore you with the details. Okay, let's apply all that to a real example. I've downloaded the CHIRPS precipitation data for the Tapi River Basin of India using Climate Engine. Check out my CHIRPS video if you're not sure how to do this. Okay, here is our data from the Tapi Basin. It starts January 1st, 1981. Shift control arrow down until the 31st August of 2022. We have over 152,000 days of data. Let's go back to the top. The first thing which we should do is convert it into a table. Go to Home, Format as Table, and let's use this gray looking thing. Press OK, Table Design, switch off the filter button, and we've made our table. Another thing which we'll do is name the table data. Okay, our data is looking good. What we're going to calculate here is the season and the water year. We have quite a big data table here, so it's better if we develop our formulas in a little smaller table, which I've already prepared here. So you can see we have one day for each month of the year, and we'll develop our seasons formula in here and our water year formula in here. So this is India. The water year runs from June to May. And also I've written down the seasons here. There's four of them. So we've got the winter season starting in January and ending in February. Pre-monsoon, which goes from March, April, May. The southwestern monsoon, which is June, July, August, September, 4 months. And post-monsoon, October, November, December. So the start months are recorded here. This is very important. Okay, let's develop the seasons formula. First thing I want to do is calculate the month from these particular dates. So just type in month, click on the date, press enter. So what we have here are the 12 months of the year corresponding to these days here. Okay, next step, what we're going to do is use the lookup formula. So equals, just type in look, and here we go, lookup. press comma, and now it's looking for an array. So we're going to use the curly brackets, open and close, and close the formula. Now this will give us an error, so I'm going to put a little dash in front of it so that it is a text. Okay, now we're going to work inside of our array. The first thing I want to do is copy the first category, which is the winter season. There was a control C, control V, press comma, take the next one, control C, control V, comma. Okay, so these are all of our seasons. What is important is to put them into inverted commas. So you keep them separated by a comma, but the text has to be inside inverted commas. This is all the descriptive text. We put a semicolon in front of it, and then in front of that we're going to put the start month. So we've got four different seasons here in order of this sequence, and now we're going to put the start month. So number 1, comma, 3, 6, comma, and 10. So you see each one of these four numbers is the start month of each of these seasons. Let's get rid of the text sign and press enter. Okay, it's worked very well. So we have winter season, January, February, pre-monsoon, the southwest monsoon, and the post-monsoon. Seems to have worked quite well. Let's copy it across to our data table. Just grab it, control C. Go to data and be very careful here. Go into the formula bar and control V and press enter. There we go. Bob's your uncle. We have all of the seasons classified for 150,000 dates. Okay, let's do the water year. I have to be a bit careful here. The water year starts in June and ends in May. And June is month 6, okay? So what we want to do first of all is again to calculate the month. And now we're gonna use an if statement equals if, open brackets, and this is our logical test. So if the month is greater than, be careful now, it should be greater than 5, which is May, okay? Comma, value of true is the year, be careful now, okay, the year of the date, plus 1. If not, we just put the year of that particular date. Okay, brackets to close, press enter. Seems to have worked quite well, so 2021 is up to May, and 2022 is starting from 1st of June of 2021. Okay, let's copy that formula across. Grab it, control C, control V, press enter. So this is 1981, and we see the change over here. The 1st of June of 87 is water year 1988. Okay, so formula is working. The next thing which we're going to do is make some graphics. Go to insert, and what we're going to do is insert a pivot chart and a pivot table. Press enter. The data range is data, that's okay. Press okay. We're now in a new sheet. Let's just rename the sheet. What we're going to do is first of all put the water year into the rows, and then the CHIRPS precipitation as values. And it's got sum of CHIRPS precipitation. So you can see the total annual precipitation for each water year from 1981 up to now, but be careful, maybe 81 is not complete because it's missing the 1980 data, so we should really start in 1982. There seems to be an upward trend. Okay, let's just first of all get rid of all the field buttons on the chart. And another thing is I'm going to change the design to a line chart. Use this one here. Press OK. Let's add some titles to the chart. Go to Design, Add Chart Element, Axis Titles. This is the water year. There seems to be an upward trend in our data. As I mentioned before, this water year is not complete, so we should remove 1981. The way we do that is we go to Pivot Table Analyze, Insert Slicer, and we'll have one for the water year. And we'll just press, I think it's Control, that's it. And also, 2023 is definitely not complete. All right, there definitely seems to be an upward trend for the total CHIRPS precipitation in the Taipei Basin from 1982 to 2021. Let's see how that changes with the season. Grab the season, put it in the columns. And there you go. I think all we'll do is we'll just move the chart to a new sheet called Chart. Okay, here we can see that the precipitation is mostly increasing during the monsoon time. The rest seems to be not changing very much. In fact, there's not much rainfall down there anyway. But definitely the monsoon period is increasing. That's from June, July, August, September. We can add a trend line to this. A linear one is fine. Okay, so that's it. Just a quick demonstration of what we can do in Excel very rapidly using some formulas, pivot tables, and pivot charts. I hope you've enjoyed the video and see you in the next one.